So we're going to start with the value of Holocaust survivor testimony. And I want to direct this question to Stephen from the Fortunoff Video Archive. What do you see as the value of Holocaust survivor testimony?
Thanks, Lauren, for that question. And thanks, Harvey, for organizing this panel. It's really nice to be a part of it. So the value of Holocaust testimony, where do I begin? I could start, I think, and this is where the video archive, the Fortunoff Video Archive really begins, which is it's a value in and of itself for the survivors who gave testimony. So our organization was founded by survivors and children of survivors and other members of the community with a connection to the history of the Holocaust. And really, the opportunity for survivors to come into a studio at Yale, or when we began in the homes of the members of the survivor community, to give testimony, to talk about their entire life story and the pain of remembering what occurred to them and their families during the period that we call the Holocaust, was in itself a service to the survivor community, right? So in a way, our mission sort of ends there at the moment where we give survivors a chance to tell their story and you know, to have a voice. Beyond that, of course, there is really an invaluable historical document that testimony represents, and you can point to hundreds and hundreds of really important works that have been based on testimony or use testimony to make their argument. If we look at one of the important contributions of testimony to the writing of history, is this. It really begins a kind of seismic historiographical shift in how we write and think about the Holocaust, moving from perpetrator documentation, German documents, to the view of the witnesses, the victims, and the survivors. And that's a really important shift in how we think about the history of the Holocaust. And that, I think, is due in great part to testimony.